Hey guys, I'm Said, and today I'm gonna show you how to install Kali Linux 2016 along with Windows 10. And if you are using older version of Kali Linux and Windows, you can also follow the instructions. So first of all, go to kalilinux.org, then go to download. There will be a link in the description. You can download Kali Linux 64-bit ISO file or 32-bit. I'll recommend you download 64-bit. It's well, if you are but you can also download Kali Linux Lite, what is just 8.8 GB. I'm gonna download 64-bit. After that, open your browser again and search for PowerSO. Here I'm gonna use PowerSO for making bootable USB. I've used several software for but I got PowerSO is best for Linux, so I'm gonna download it. I'm gonna download PowerSO 64-bit as I'm using 64-bit operating system. Then after downloading, open your folder, then install PowerSO. So just click PowerSO x64, then click agree, next, then install. Then close it. Our PowerSO is installed. Now enter your USB, then format that, select NTFS or FAT, whatever, then start, then okay. After formatting your USB, just open Kali Linux that we installed and open with PowerSO. Then wait for 4 seconds as using free version, then click continue unregistered. That's it. Then go to tools, then select create bootable USB, then okay. As I'm using a free version, so I have to wait for 4 seconds. So after 4 seconds, click continue with unregistered, then select your USB, then make sure all is perfect, then click start, then okay. Now click right button, then select manage, then disk management. Open disk management. Here we'll find your partition, all partitions, and I have to make some unallocated space where I'm gonna install my Kali Linux. So just let me check how much free space we got. So we got have almost 50 GB free space, so I can make it at least 40 GB. Now I'm gonna make 24 GB or 25 GB unallocated space for Kali Linux. So click right button, then shrink and enter your desired space. So I'm gonna enter 202.205.0.0, what means 20 GB. So I have got 25 GB unallocated space. After that, restart your computer or shut down your computer and enter your pendrive. After that, open your BIOS. You can be for my case it's F2 button for open BIOS. It can be different for you and it can be look different for you case, because this is very old version BIOS. So first, make removal disk as first priority. So here I got removal devices first priority and F10 for save changes. Then after saving that, then select graphical install. Then select your language, then hit continue. Then your state, area or area. Here I got no internet connection, so I got this. So hit continue, then continue, then select your host name, then enter your password. Now select manual and hit continue. Then here we'll find your partition, all partition. I got 37 GB where I installed my Windows. So select your free space, then select automatically partition the free space. It will automatically. So now all files in one partition, then continue. So we got 1.1 GB swap and 2.25 GB EXT4 where our Kali Linux will be installed. So let's check its mount option, default label on. Now finish partition and hit continue. Then write changes, select yes and hit continue. Now use network mirror server, select yes, then continue, then continue again, and select your archive mirror country. I'm gonna select a United States, then continue and continue and continue. Here select yes, then hit continue, then select DivySDA, then hit continue, then so now everything is done, so hit continue. So now your computer will be start. Now you can select Kali Linux or Windows. So let's check our Windows is working perfectly. So it's working well. So I'm gonna restart my computer again, then so now select Kali Linux. So it's also working perfectly. So thank you guys, thank you for watching. If you got any question or any problem, you can comment here. I will try to answer you.